Hey, Crazy Ron here, and we're back with Ghost Recon Wildlands. So between last session and now, got a change of clothes, changed my camos, toned back some of the graphical settings. So now I'm staying above 50 frames a second instead of dipping between 40 and 60, because I have the game capped at 60, but it still tends to dip even closer to a mid 30s in some places. But now I got it fixed straight on 60, 50, something like that.
Hostiles in the area, stay frosty.
Game doesn't
We got
feel
a Sicario.
terribly
Be aware,
optimized.
close to the camp entrance.
And I even had to turn off SLI because I was getting a lot of graphical issues. But yeah, now we've moved on from Barbechos after that really pain in the ass vehicle escort mission. And now we're in Pucara, which. This has to do with the influence branch of the cartel. So right now, we're trying to find information about the DJ who runs the radio station that kind of helps, expand propaganda in Bolivia. And so we got to go and try to figure out where he is. So right now, we're gonna go talk to one of his old bodyguards and see if he knows anything. What's this? Light machine gun short barrel. I might have to snag that while I'm here. But there's a story mission over here, so I'll figure it out. It is getting to evening.
If we start shooting, ID your targets, people. We know Perico's ex-bodyguard Ruiz is working at this mine, and we need him alive for questioning.
Need him alive for questioning, so I just can't engage with reckless abandon. Is that what I'm getting? Is that what I'm getting from this?
Got eyes on the captain.
Gonna try out this new
Tango.
scope. I mean, I've had it for a
Got a good
while, but the
target.
main reason why I don't use it is mostly because of its difficulty
Hostile
to
down.
use at range. But yeah, between last session and this session, I did some grinding too, like gathered some resources, bought up some skill
Deploying
points,
drone.
or
They got alarms
bought
rigged
up some
up.
skills.
I got a target carrying submachine guns.
I mean,
Sniper. Top of the
I
tower.
decided not
Spotted
to
one with
record
submachine
all of
guns.
that or put a video up
Target
on
number
all that.
five.
Stuff gets pretty old after a while. I
Tango
also have to
down.
tone down the actually, no, I didn't tone down the ambient inclusion. I did tone down some of the terrain quality and stuff like that. Stuff that I usually carry on Ultra, but the game just does not
I
like to
got eyes on
run
Perico's former
correctly.
bodyguard. Let's talk to him.
Or well. Also foregoing the SR635 today. I
Watch your
mean, the
fire.
good
We
thing
want
is
to
with
hit
this
these
scope,
civilians.
I can actually, tell. Or I can actually engage at shorter ranges. I tried to. I'm still on advanced, which is like one below the hardest difficulty, extreme. I was trying to make my own,
Supplies will
like,
buy us a
custom
lot of goodwill from the
difficulty.
rebels.
Because you can change the HUD up. Like a lot. You have a lot of granularity with the HUD. What I wanted to do was make it so that every nope, oh, there's texture glitches. Choo-choo. There's a guy out here. Did he just get run over? Well, according to my minimap, an enemy just got ran over and my teammate just got ran over. Anyway, back to my original point. I wanted to make it like a custom difficulty where every single one of my HUD elements was off except for the minimap. That was a total farce. Everything but my minimap would be gone off the screen, and I could still, see my detection meter, but that was impossible to do because the minimap is good for. The minimap, I think, is necessary for like situation awareness because the game doesn't really do that very well, or any really most video games don't. So I wanted to
Angle.
leave the minimap up, but that's it. Problem is, I couldn't disable, like, I want to disable in-world tagging and just base all my information on the minimap. But I could disable in-world tagging, but I couldn't separate that from the detection meter because the detection meter is what? Power lines, yo. I wanted the detection meter because yes, I can hear audio cues for detection, but it's really, really, really hard to get a sense of how quickly you are about to get detected. So, enough rambling.
You Arturo Ruiz? DJ Perico's former bodyguard?
Perico? Man, fuck that guy. That pinche puto shot my dog.
He shot what the fuck? Friend?
No, man, he shot my dog, mi perro.
Did nothing to no one. Really?
Your pet? What for?
The fuck?
Puta madre, Perico was trying to smoke weed out of an AR-15. Fucking thing went off and got Paloma. Still have nightmares about that. Wake up with the shakes and shit.
What the fuck?
Perico, give me his real name. A photo too.
Man. Perico's real name is Marco Garcia. I don't have no photo, but I hope you kill that motherfucker.
For a dog? Freaking Latino country music, man. Shit. Well, let's cross the freaking tracks. That,
and all we got was a name as common as Marco Garcia.
The activity will work their magic. Send them the name and maybe they can zap us back a picture so we can ID the asshole.
He's history.
You think that echo would resound a bit more?
Yo, I got a weapons case here.
Good.
Damn, this is an interesting mine. I might wander around here for a bit and move on to the next story mission. Okay, so I guess we got a lead. Whoops. We got a lead on the guy's house in this town here. And despite what I said, I switched back to my SR635. I don't know, I'm just really loving this thing. It is my second most killed gun too. Or second gun with second most kills. There you go. Words. My ACR is the first. It used to be my R5. Really love that thing, but I don't know. Kinda grow fond in a part of it. Time makes fools of us all. So I'm gonna grab this metal first, and then I'm gonna go to Perico's home. I guess he has a big ass house over here. We are operating at night. The SR635 for realistic reasons is actually more silent than the SR25, which is pretty good in urban environments, so that's why I'm kinda going with it. Although admittedly the biggest problem is just, you know, getting there. Although I feel like trying to treat this game a little realistic in how I would handle, you know, my weapon choices. And I feel like
Tango down.
I feel like an SR-25 would just be too bulky and heavy to deal with. That's what's also weird. Like the audio cue for the guns in the game, or the audio track. It's like when I fired, that sounded like two shots to me. I don't know if anyone else feels that way, but it felt like sounded like two shots, and I only fired the one, according to my ammo counter. Okay, so I need to avoid the spotlight. Hopefully there's no freaking Santa Blanca car going on by here. Freaking break my concealment. I wonder if I should shoot out that light. That's above me.
Hostile down.
That was fucking close.
Hoop. God, that guy just fell the fuck back. I mean, it's late at night. Don't know if anyone's really sleeping yet. That almost went south quickly. That's just ammo. There's Unidad on the other side of town here.
Watch for civilians. We don't want to kill somebody by mistake.
Tango down.
We all kill with a purpose.
Got another tango.
Yeah, there's a lot of guys near that metal. I don't like that. Don't know if he'll show well in the video.
That's a kill.
But I mean, I could clearly see with my brightness settings. Like, this isn't even bright. Like, this is just default gamma. I guess I should just leave the NVGs on for anyone that actually wants to see. I don't know, it still seems like... I guess my monitor or my... I'm using a TV screen. Maybe it just seems like it's brighter than it actually is. Hey, is there anything in here?
Found a Santa Blanca medal. This will make a nice souvenir. I think Santa Blanca gives out a lot of these.
Alright. Continuing on with my mission. Third person's broken, yo. Use it to peek around corners.
We'll let the rebels know where to find these supplies. They could pay us back later. That's a kill.
Yeah, I'll leave Unidad alone, because there's like a high chance that that's just going to end up pissing everyone the fuck off. But yeah, this is like an interesting weapon, because it uses unique ammunition. This weapon I'm using right now. And the game is called an SR-635, I believe. My memory serves me correct, but it's actually a Knights Armament PDW. It's a 6.35mm by... I don't remember what the length of the cartridge is, but... It uses proprietary ammo, which isn't that great for, you know, ammunition or logistics, but... Because there's no one up here. But I guess it was a specially engineered and designed round to be fired from short barrels while maintaining energy. I'm so glad no one has, like, night vision goggles to see my IR laser. Which, you know, the infrared spectrum is pretty much only visible to electronic equipment. Like night vision goggles. Although now that I think about it, there's where that sniper went. He used to be up there. Although now that I think about it, if they have such a thing as security cameras in this game, which they should, considering they're like cartel people, they should have cameras everywhere. Maybe not Watchdogs level of everywhere, but they should definitely notice the laser in like the camera feeds.
Rico isn't here. Scour up any kind of intel you can.
So that's a guy.
Watch your fire. We don't want to hit any civilians.
Hostile down.
I was really convinced that that second guy I shot in that group really easily. Dude's got a nice studio. Oh, thanks, lighting. just for me.
We've got schematics of some kind. Fractal antenna, maybe.
If Perico's using that fractal antenna to broadcast, that drawing might help the activity get a beat on his location.
Alright, well. There's another mission to the northwest, I believe, so I'm definitely gonna hit that up. Alright, so interestingly enough, this is in a snowier part of the map. Never thought I'd see, I never thought I'd get to a snow part of the map this early. But there's, a lot of enemy presence here. I'm glad it's nighttime, though. I want that skill point. Need to figure out how to navigate over there. Let's see, if I lurk in the back here, enemies probably won't travel back here.
Yo, cartel gunman, near that turret.
Oh, thanks. Spot the guy that's farthest away from me.
Stay out of sight. We're closing in on the radio station. Let's see if Perico's on the job.
That was risk. There could have been a guy in here. I wonder if my pistol is actually quieter than my assault rifle, because I would definitely try and use that instead. I guess I can't really pick them out. Yeah, noise reduction is like pretty much dead silent. So I guess handguns would be way better in closer reaches of people. It's kind of weird they don't tend to notice you knocking shit over, though. And this is also a pretty tall building. Oh, there's two in here.
He's history.
Hold up, they're gonna spot you. You poked the hornet's nest.
Yeah, so see, like I said, quieter.
Keep it quiet, they know we're here.
I don't know about how they know we're here. He just heard his friends die downstairs.
This metal has a coca plant on it. That's kind of cool.
Shit, we got a sniper.
Shit. Well, god damn it. Well, at least I got my skill point. See, it's going to be tricky now because it's starting to become daylight. Not a huge fan of that prospect. Although there's not a lot of people on the street here. They're all staying in the buildings, which, despite it being a winter, weather outside, they leave the doors open still. Guys, I guess these guys don't know anything about OPSEC.
Maybe he ran. Maybe somebody we talked to tipped him off. But he's still broadcasting.
Bowman, we're at the station. DJ Perico isn't here, but there's still a broadcast coming through.
He's using that station as a relay to boost his signal, and we can't hack in without the encryption key. Use the drone to scan his antennas. Sicken can take incoming data, and we can try to trace his location by triangulating the incoming signal's strength.
Roger that.
All I understood from that phone call with Bowman was scan the antenna. We just have to keep the drone still till the scanning's done.
The drone is up.
Oh, really?
All bad. They're jamming the drone. Getting some awful interference here.
Not good. Might be a jammer in the area. You're gonna have to find and destroy that before you can scan Perico's antennas.
We're on it.
Jeez, I've been through here before, so I know there's a drone jammer somewhere here. I just don't know exactly where. So it has to be in this area. I also really hope they don't wander outside. Yeah, because I've been through here before for like skill points and stuff and collectibles. So I do know of a jammer in the area, I just don't remember where. As much as I'm tempted to just, you know, chuck shit at it to cause it to explode, I don't want to piss everyone off, because I don't know if I still need to stay undetected.
Eyes on a narco with a submachine gun, right by the container.
Well, I'll be damned. Hopefully this will be a safe spot. A llama farm.
I got a third.
Scan the rooftop antenna with the drone. So what do I do? Do I press button? I feel like if I press the button, I will explode. Because there's explosion button. There's like a sweet spot I need to hit. There you go. I literally have to be like this close to it.
Scan complete. Just hope Sigan can trace Perico.
Wow, that's it? Alright, well I guess I should exfil then. Oh, well, there's a dead spot right here where there's no enemies, so I can just sprint on out. Jeez, even if I was on extreme, this probably wouldn't be too terrible. Because the game's easy if you're not getting detected.
Schematics you found and the scan you took, we've confirmed that Perico's using a basic frequency agility program to encrypt the signal to his relay.
But to hijack the signal for Pakatari's broadcast, we still need the encryption key.
Right. We've got enough data to get you to the area of Perico's location. You need to pay him an unfriendly visit and get his encryption key.
Bowman sending through background on DJ Perico.
Well, I don't know if that'll give me any insight to his location, but, yeah. We'll go find his ass.
Nomad, my people have discovered a vehicle dispatch for a truck bringing valuable replicas to Elsueño's mausoleum. I know it's not your main task, but it's an opportunity to win your Sueño's pride.
Check. We get the chance, we'll take out the convoy before it reaches Sueño's personal shrine.
Oh. Well, we get bonus missions as well. Huh. I wonder if that's related to this mission. Or this area. Actually, it is, because El Sueño's mausoleum is here. So, it's pretty grandiose. We might get to that last.